So, without further ado, here we go. Standard is a format where you really want to be playing first, I've come to learn. Lots of lands come into play tapped, so if you have an awkward hand on the draw, a lot of times you're just not even in the game. Also, I have cards like Syncopate, Dissolve, which are really, really good if I'm not behind on the board, but pretty awful if I do find myself falling behind. Alright, well, this hand's great. It's pretty much exactly what the deck is setting out to do. Make land drops, Supreme Verdict, to bridge the gap, and eventually Planar Cleansing. So, okay, Sacred Foundry could be any number of decks. If this was an island, I'd bottom it, but I think I need to keep all my sources of white mana for the Verdict and Cleansing. So yeah, it could be Burn, could be Red Devotion, could be Naya, could be Hexproof, I guess, although I don't know if that deck plays Basic Mountain. Well, turn 2 Lightning Strike you means only one thing, ladies and gentlemen. My opponent is going to try to kill me with Burn. We have a Dissolve to combat that. Jace is actually okay against Burn. Well, I'm not going to dissolve a shock. I will dissolve a 3-point or 4-point burn spell. And I'll probably dissolve a Chandra's Phoenix too. I think I'd prefer to just Verdict that away, keep my dissolve. Alright, so Scry and probably use Jace plus one. I actually find the most common way to actually win a game against Burn is to ultimate Jace, because they usually want to throw all their damage straight at you, so you end up just taking up Jace, you know, minorly reducing the damage the creatures are dealing you, and eventually you're at 8, and then you win. Okay, that was an interesting choice. He elected to attack me, but Magma Jet the Jace. Yeah, I feel like I have everything I need. There's nothing I'm really trying to draw into, so I'll just keep plussing. I could think about Main Phase Revelation here. Yeah. Now that I think a little bit more about it, that's a good play. There's not much sorcery speed that I really desperately am going to need to dissolve, so I'd rather just play around Skullcrack. Alright, so killing off Jace, that's fine. I have another, and this time I can play it with Dissolve backup. At this point, the game is just, you know, slowing things down, making land drops, looking for revelations. That's worth a dissolve. Because I don't want to cleansing away my own Jace. It's definitely going to the top. Short of revelation, that's one of the best cards I can draw. Absolutely no reason to attack with Mutavault. You know, it's inconceivable that I would win by attacking for 2 10 times. I'll just eventually ultimate a Jace or find Elspeth or Chain Revolutions until my opponent concedes. That's fine. Pretty much bottoming anything besides a card draw spell, or I guess a dissolve. And that's probably going to be game. So I have 10 lands in play, meaning if I wanted to hold up Dissolve, I'd be revving for 4. Could also just wait, do nothing. Or I could just rev for everything, but then Skullcrack leaves the game, I guess, still up for grabs. Waiting certainly favors me, so I have no problem doing that. Every land that my opponent draws is stone dead draw, and every land that I draw is more life, more cards. Boros Charm is worth dissolving. It's actually one of the most powerful cards in his deck. When you factor in that I don't care about life gain from War Leader's Helix, there's just nothing really more powerful than Boros Charm. Huh. And I'm immediately proven wrong. Okay, so I guess that means what, that I'm going to lose my Jace? Still can't kill Elspeth, which is good for me. Alright, I think I'm gonna rev for 6, leaving 3 mana open, and then if I find Verdict, great. If not, then at least I can still hold up Dissolve mana, and I'm playing around Skullcrack by doing it on my main phase. Actually, let me pause for a second and think about what happens if you just Monstrous as the Dragon. So I'll obviously be passing the turn with 7 cards and 18 life. So he'll Monstrosity deal me 7, but then he still can't attack for lethal. So I should be safe making this play. Stormbreath Dragon actually makes the game interesting. Well, if I hadn't been quite so far ahead, like, if I'd only been ahead by a little bit, the surprise Stormbreath Dragon might have just gotten me. Alright, so what do I want here? Negate is very good. Don't think I need Jace. Blind Obedience. I guess anything that gains me life is fine. Last Breath for sure. Deicide. Yeah, I don't think I need that. Basically, I just want all my cards that gain life and everything that draws me to a card that gains life. Verdict is probably cheap enough that it's worth it, especially if he's leaving in Boros Reckoners and or Stormbreath Dragons. I'll just be winning the game with Elixir. So what else do I want to cut here? I guess the next thing would be eating into Divinations here. Maybe I'll do this.